Pastor John Heggie's best-selling book, Four Blood Moons, will play in theaters one night this month. Blood moons occur several times in Scripture during significant times. 2015 will have four blood moons, all occurring on Jewish feast days. The film will examine the significance of the blood moon cycle for Israel, the Middle East, and the rest of the world. CBN News terror analyst Erick Stakelbeck makes an appearance in the movie, and he joins us now. Erick, what's behind the recent blood moon phenomena?
Well, look, Mark, this is very amazing what's going on right now. Basically, we have what's called a tetrad of blood moons. Now, that's a series of four blood moons in a row. We see single blood moons, Mark, fairly frequently. But this tetrad that I'm talking about has great historical significance in that every time we seem to see a series of four blood moons in a row, they occur on Jewish feast days, on Passover and Sukkot, over a two-year span. So historically, we've seen in 1492, for instance, we had four blood moons. What do we have? The Jewish people were expelled from Spain. Columbus discovered the New World, which became a safe haven for the Jewish people eventually. In 1948, we had a tetrad of these blood moons. Israel obviously was reborn as a nation, won its independence. 1967, again, a series of these four blood moons occurring on Jewish feast days, we had the Six-Day War. So again now, Mark, we're in the midst of four blood moons. We have two left, one coming up on Passover 2015 and one coming up in the fall during the Feast of Tabernacles or Sukkot. So two of these blood moons left. We're in the middle of this tetrad that I mentioned, Mark. And historically, again, when we've seen a tetrad of four blood moons in a row on Jewish feast days, we've seen monumentous things happen for Israel and the Jewish people.
What role do you play in this new film?
Well, I'm kind of a talking head in this film, Mark. I kind of give more of analysis on, number one, the broader story of what's going on in the world right now, what's going on in Israel, what's going on in the Middle East, because, again, these blood moons have historically taken place during earth-shattering moments for the land of Israel and the Jewish people. So I'm giving, number one, just my analysis of what's going on in the Middle East, how it's basically on fire, how Israel's in a lot of trouble right now in terms of being surrounded by its enemies. But I also give some biblical perspective on, look, the book of Genesis, God says clearly to Abraham, I will bless those who bless you. I will curse those who curse you, when he's talking about Israel and the Jewish people. So I give some biblical perspective, Mark, on the fate of any nation that turns against Israel.
Why is it important, Erick, for people to see the movie?
I think, number one, it's very well done, Mark. Look, this is done by a top-notch production team. It's going to be in theaters for one day only, but nationwide. Very well done. It's entertaining. It's informative. It's interesting. It's going to keep you riveted to the screen. I've seen an advanced version, Mark, already, an advanced screening, and I loved it. I couldn't look away. My wife loved it as well, and she's not as into this stuff as I am. But I think the main reason people need to see it is because, look, we are, in my view, Mark, in perilous times right now. We are in biblical times right now, in my view, the way I see things. And I think this movie helps to explain the times we're in right now, because even people who aren't Christians right now, Mark, instinctively in their gut, they sense that something's not right. Major things are happening. And Jesus said there would be signs in the moon and in the stars and the heavens. And right now, these blood moons are a sign, I believe, possibly a sign of the times we're in. It just seems, wow, Mark, to see a series of blood moons. Again, it's happened only during these very significant times in the history of Israel and the Jewish people. Israel's up against the wall right now, isolated. The whole world is against it, basically. Even our current administration is not kind to Israel. So to see these blood moons happening now, when Iran, Israel's mortal enemy, is close to acquiring a nuclear weapon, is it a coincidence? I don't know, but I think it's very, very interesting. And I encourage people to check the film out and decide for yourself.
So again, we already had two in 2014 and now two more in 2015, correct?
We did. I don't want to confuse people, get in the weeds with them, Mark. The key thing here is that when we have, once in a while, we do have blood moons appear on their own. But to see a series of four in a row like this is very, very rare. It's only happened a handful of times in the past 600 years or so. And when it has happened, Mark, It has always happened, whether it's 1948, 67, 1492, during periods of great historical significance for Israel and the Jewish people. And the way things are going right now in the Middle East and with Israel, we may be entering a very significant historical period once again. So perhaps these blood moons are a signpost from the God of Israel.
All right. Erick Stakelbeck, thanks so much. And to find out more about the four blood moons and see our exclusive coverage, visit us at cbnnews.com and follow Erick at his Twitter handle, Stax33.